Hello everyone and welcome to another review on ChinaMobileMac.com. Today we will have a closer look at the Neumann K18. This is the newest octa-core phone made by Neumann and currently one of the most affordable octa-core phones in its category. The Neumann K18 is equipped with a 1.7 GHz MT6502 octa-core processor, a 5-inch Full HD OGS IPS screen, 2 GB of RAM, 16 GB of internal memory, a 12-megapixel rear camera, a 5-megapixel front camera, and well, let's have a closer look at the phone and see how it is. Before we have a look at the phone itself, let's first see which accessories come with the Neumann K18. The phone is delivered in this box made of recycled carton, on which the Neumann logo is printed on every side. On the side you will find a small fabric loop, which you can use to slide the inner of the box out to the right. Now you can see the place where the smartphone is placed and a box on the side which contains the accessories. We did remove everything already. With the phone you get a small envelope which contains the user manual as well as the warranty document. A small tool for opening the slots of the phone is placed on top as well. The user manual comes with the phone, is in Chinese and explains the usage of Android as well as how you can insert the SIM and micro SD cards. The warranty document that comes with the phone is completely in Chinese as well, so it is not of much use. This small power supply comes with the phone as well and has a Chinese plug. EFOX Shop has included an adapter for using it with German power sockets in our case. The last accessory is this black micro USB cable. Neumann has not put any headphones or protective films into the package. In terms of the design, Neumann has done quite a good job with the K18, as the device is quite different from most other Chinese phones. On the black front, most of you will probably notice the large black phone call speaker first. Next to the phone call speaker there is a status LED, a front camera, a proximity sensor and a light sensor. Below there is the 5-inch screen and again below we find 3 touch buttons for menu, home and back. These are back illuminated but you almost cannot see it. When looking on the phone from the side, you immediately notice how thin it is. Here we do find a micro SD slot, a micro SIM slot and a volume rocker on the left. On the lower side, we find nothing except a voice microphone and a USB port. On the right side, we find the on-off switch as well as another slot, this time for a normal sized SIM card. On the upper side, we only find a 3.5mm headphone jack. When looking at the rear of the phone, we find the rear camera along with a LED flash on the upper half, embedded into the rubber-like material of the housing. Below, an aluminum cover is placed, on which we can find the Neumann logo. Below this cover is the opening for the media speaker. The cover above the media speaker can be removed, by the way, uncovering 2 screws which hold the aluminum cover in place. After removing them, you can open the phone and take a look at the built-in non-replaceable lithium polymer cell. With some experience and the right lithium polymer cell, you might be able to actually replace the battery. As we did expect in advance, the quality of the screen inside the Neumann K18 is excellent, as Neumann is using an LG panel with a resolution of 1920x1080 pixels, also known as Full HD. During our test, the screen did satisfy us by providing an excellent picture quality, sharpness and color reproduction. Black is displayed perfectly, almost at OLED niveau. When coming very close to the screen, you will have no chance to detect single pixels. Even through the camera, it is quite hard to see them. This enables the screen to display HD content with an impressive amount of details and sharpness and makes fonts looking like they were printed. It also makes the screen very easy on the eyes. The viewing angles of the panel are good as well. Colors are not inverting and the brightness is going down just a little bit. Here on the video, it is not looking like in reality. Something we did notice, however, is that the screen is showing a reddish tint when looking at it from the sides, but this is an issue a lot of LG panels have. All in all, the screen is great and can easily keep up with screens of high-end devices of well-known brands. The great reproduction of colors and details can be viewed here again within the wallpaper gallery. In our benchmarks, the Neumann K18 reached average results for a MT6502 Full HD phone. In the AnTuTu benchmark, the phone reached 26,613 points, which results in a place between the HTC One and the Samsung Galaxy S4 in the ranking table. In the 3D mark, the Inhuman K18 reached 7,027 points in the Unlimited benchmark, 4,176 points in the 1080p benchmark, and 5,744 points in the 720p benchmark. In the Willamo HTML5 benchmark, the phone reached 1,978 points, and in the middle benchmark, it reached 662 points. The last benchmark we ran on the phone was GFX Bench. Here the phone reached 521 points. Something we did notice while running benchmarks, the device is getting really hot on its upper rear and front when running demanding apps. This could be quite uncomfortable for some people. The performance of the Inhuman K18 in real life use is good. As you can see here, the operating system is running very smooth and apps are opening up fast. Also, a picture gallery with quite some images in it is not a problem. More complex apps with network access such as Flipboard in this example are running smooth and flawlessly as well. While browsing the internet, some small lags show up, but this is something all MT6592 phones are showing and is probably caused by the software. However, pages are loading fast and thanks to the 2 GB of RAM, the usage of multiple tabs isn't a problem. While switching between large sites, they will not reload and a slowdown is not noticeable. During our gaming tests, the Inhuman K18 reached good results as well. The only negative thing here is the intense heat, which we mentioned before and could be uncomfortable for some people. Here you can see the performance of Asphalt 8 on the phone. The game is running smooth even though it is very demanding towards the CPU and GPU. Graphics are looking really good here. Our second gaming test was Dead Trigger 2. This game was running smooth as well on the highest settings. Real Racing 3, however, was lagging a bit as we are used to from other MT6592 phones, but was playable though. Thank you. Watching HD contents on the Newman K18 is great thanks to the good screen, and the processor is of course powerful enough for it. In this test, we mainly want to show you the audio quality of the internal speaker as far as this is possible with the camera microphone. Here we want to say that the speaker is quite loud and thus almost never creates scratchy noises even on full volume. Unfortunately, there is no bass playback at all. The Newman K18 was able to satisfy us during our test by providing a good 2G and 3G reception quality. During 3 days of testing the device, we never met a situation without network, and also a 3G connection was possible in areas with bad network coverage. The Wi-Fi reception quality was good as well, and we did not have any issues in the whole building. Only outside, the Wi-Fi connection broke off. Bluetooth was working good as well in our test, and its range was around 10 meters under free view. The GPS performance, however, is somewhat disappointing. It was not possible to get a GPS fix without deleting the mtkgps.dat file. After this, the fix took a bit about 1 minute. This time, unfortunately, was not getting shorter later on. The reception quality of GPS was not great as well. Only 5 satellites were found, and an accuracy of 4 meters was reached. In the house, the signal broke off immediately. Also, if you are between some houses, you will encounter issues with the GPS. Because of this, we consider the GPS as unreliable. The battery life is surprisingly good, even though the Newman K18 only has a 2000 mAh battery. With a fully charged battery, you should easily get over the day. If you are saving power, you might even reach 1.5 days. Disappointing is that you cannot change the battery of the phone, except you have the necessary knowledge of taking it apart and have a replacement cell that fits into the phone. However, the battery should last at least a year, which is the life cycle of a smartphone for most people. Charging the battery takes a bit long. The Newman K18 is fully charged after over 2 hours. The camera of the Newman K18 is taking pictures with a resolution of 13 megapixels and an aperture of f2.2. The quality is okay but could be better. The camera is creating quite sharp images, but sometimes it is lacking contrast and under direct light it has some issues. Another issue is that the images have a slight bluish tint to it, which lets the colors look kinda cold. Videos are recorded in full HD and are showing the same characteristics. The audio quality is good, a video demo can be viewed in our YouTube channel as usual. Pictures with the internal flash are surprisingly good and with a low amount of noise. The flash is quite powerful and managed to light up smaller rooms. Our final conclusion? The Newman K18 did satisfy us with its small body at only 6.19 mm on the thinnest part and an average thickness of 6.67 mm. In addition to that, it provides you with quite some processing power thanks to the MT6592 8-core processor and has quite a good battery life for the 2000 mAh cell inside the phone. We did also like the overall build quality of the phone. The housing seems very solid and does not creak upon applying pressure. On the sides and parts of the back, It is made of a rubber-like material which ensures a decent amount of grip. When looking on the price tag of the phone, you notice that you receive quite a lot for the price here. Disappointing, however, was the GPS reception quality, the built-in non-replaceable battery, partly the heat generation of the phone, and the camera, which could be a bit better to make the overall package perfect. Whoever is not distracted by these flaws will get a full purchase recommendation by us. The Neumann K18 has been provided to us by eFox Shop, where you can buy it for 192 euros at this time. A link as well as detailed pictures of the phone you can find in our in-depth written review on chinamobilemag.com, which is linked below the video. We hope that you did like our video and hope that it was helpful for you. Of course, we are happy to see your comments, a thumbs up, and maybe even a subscription to our channel. Thanks for watching and bye!